Let's investigate how IT Advisor are going to help us to save some energy being used by cooling units inside the data center. In this example, we have a room with two main units that are supplying the cold air into the room. Yeah? And these two units are being set up with 17 degrees Celsius as a supply temperature. With these settings, we are able to examine how it's gonna look like the cooling situation in this room. And this is the picture of the room with supply temperature 17 degrees. Yeah. Now, we could possibly simulate and change the supply temperature inside the IT Advisor to investigate here if the situation is gonna change. Yeah. Once supply temperature going to be increased, for example, with 2 degrees Celsius, so reaching in that case 19 degrees Celsius. Yeah. So increasing this temperature and examining the room, and the same room, give us this picture of the room. So now we're going to see two pictures of the same room with supply temperature 17 degrees and supply temperature 19 degrees here. After close investigation, we see that there is no really difference between these two pictures. So this means from the cooling perspective, we could use the supply temperature 19 degrees here, and we will be still able to make sure that the operation of our data center will be not at risk, and the cooling will be still as efficient as it is with 17 degrees. Yeah. But from the perspective of energy consumption, we're gonna very quickly discover that we have far lower energy consumption if we use the supply temperature 19 degrees. So every degree is going to help us to save some energy. So now let's have a look on example inside the IT Advisor and have a look in a different room and see how this could be achieved inside our EcoStruxure IT Advisor tool. So here's the room with the supply temperature 20 degrees. Yeah, we got here a couple of cooling units, yeah. And if I just hover over on the unit, I see what's the supply temperature. As you can see, it says 20 degrees, yeah. All racks are being properly cooled, yeah. And if I switch to the 3D view mode and run the calculation of the cooling inside this room, I'm gonna receive this heat map of this data center. I'm gonna save this and gonna save it as a 20 degrees heat map. Now we're gonna come back to our 2D view and we're gonna change the supply temperature of our cooling units to 22 degrees. Yeah. So to do that, I'm just gonna have to edit quickly the cooling properties of my cooling units, yeah, and change the supply temperature. So as I do that, you probably notice, yeah, that in some areas, yeah, the temperature in the temperature for the racks is increasing. Yeah, this that green bar on the rack. Some cooling units are being stressed less or more, depends really which cooling unit is being at the moment set up with the new supply temperature. And here we did already change to the 22nd. Here one more unit has to be changed to 22 degrees. This one as well. So now we change the supply temperatures for every cooling unit inside our room to 22 degrees. So we're going to examine this room and see how it changed the situation inside this room. So I'm switching to 3D mode and calculating again the temperature inside this room, and I'm going to take a screenshot and call it 22 degrees. So after that, let's compare these two different views of the same room. So here is our room with 20 degrees supply temperature. As we can see, if I'm gonna change the temperature to 22 degrees, the change is minimal. We can see that based on the colors around the racks, yeah, in the front and the back of the racks, yeah. So let's go back to the 20 degrees. This is the 20 degrees. The temperature is a little bit lower. So we see this dark blue color here. Yeah. And if I switch to 22 degrees, yeah, I see the change. But as you can probably recognize, the change is so low, so minimal, that we actually are able to operate this data center with that new settings of 22 degrees of supply temperature, yeah, without any risk of operation of our data center. At the same time, IT Advisor allows us as well to also have a look on the data that is measured by the sensors, yeah. So this is the same room, but this time we're gonna utilize the sensors that being placed inside this room.